الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان في رسول الله أسوة حسنة، صدق الله العظيم. الحمد لله. Respected and honorable Hazrat Mawlana Abdul Rahman, Hazrat Mawlana Asad Maki, all the great luminaries and shuyukh and scholars that are seated here in present, and all those that are the aashiq and lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran makes mention, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْحَكَمِينَ أَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I have now the most gracious, the most merciful Lord of the world who has revealed the Quran through the media of that creation who is created from light, and that is Jibreel, ala qalbi, on the heart of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to warn the people. And if we're looking at warning generally, it is somebody that reprimands. But Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's warning was done with hikmah, with love, and with mercy. You take the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what we see, and Allah highlights in the Holy Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You take the great character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is an example for all of mankind. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent unto this world to know perfect character. When Allah speaks of his level of character, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. So high and so great is his character, لَعَلَىٰ, that all of man put together, all our good character, if we do have, if we gather it, this is only the beginning of the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us look at Fatah Makkah, the conquest of Makkah, which took place 8 years after Hijri. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, together with 10,000 Sahaba, marched to conquer Makkah. And 2,000 that were new Muslims in Makkah joined this Muslim army. It was then one of the Muslim soldiers said, اليوم يوم الملحمة. Today is the day of revenge. For what did the Meccans and Quraysh do to the Muslims? They persecuted them. They made sanctions. They boycotted. They killed the Muslims. They drove the Muslims out of Mecca. They had to make hijrah to Ethiopia. And then they had to make hijrah to Medina Tayyibah. This is the time we can avenge. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that moment says, no, al-yawm yawmul marhama. Today is the day of mercy. It is when Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gathered the chiefs of the tribes of the Quraysh. And he says to the chiefs, do you know what I'm going to do? They said, yes, you're the son of our honorable brother and of an honorable man. You will do nothing to us. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? Idhabu, go, fa'antumul tulaba, that now you are free. This was the great character of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only showing mercy to Muslims, not only showing mercy towards those that were close to him, to the enemies of Islam, those that caused harm to the Muslims and Islam. Let us go to one more incident. You take Fudala al-Layhi. During Fatah Makkah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making tawaf around the Kaaba. Fudala al-Layhi comes with the intention to assassinate and kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He takes a dagger, places it under his arm, and covers it, and he begins his tawaf. And because he has come with a mission to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is now breathing heavily, he is nervous. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw, and he says, لِمَا تُحَدِّثُ نَفْسَكَ O Fudala, why are you now breathing so heavily? Why are you nervous? He says, أَتُوفُ أَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ I'm making tawaf, I'm remembering Allah. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by for the second time, he's breathing heavier because he wants to now kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Again Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لِمَا تُحَدِّثُ نَفْسَكَ Why are you now stuttering? Again he says, أَتُوفُ أَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ This happens three times. Wallahi, and the third time, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam places his blessed hand on the chest of Fudala al-Laythi and he makes dua. Fudala al-Laythi gives testimony. He says, until now, I did not hate anybody's name more than the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I hated the face more than the face of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But after Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam placed his hand on my chest, the most beautiful of names was the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The most beautiful of faces was that of Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is where he portrayed mercy. Towards who? Towards the enemies. That same enemy that came to assassinate him, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showered mercy. And that is what happened. It was the mercy that now invoked Fudala al-Laythi to accept his beautiful deed. I conclude by saying the word of Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, calling people towards Allah, do it silently. When his companions ask, how can we call people towards Allah silently? He says, through Hisbul Qalb, through good character. And this is what Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam portrayed. And if he can portray this character, then which man has the heart not to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Even the so-called disbelievers, you take Gandhi, you take Orwell, you take Sir Bernard Shaw, all of them accept and testify that nobody could portray and be a better example when it comes to character than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So with this in mind, conclude and make dua to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. May the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be instilled and imbibe in every single one's heart, and not only through means of tongue, through the heart and through our practical actions, and all those enemies of Islam and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah soften their hearts, let them realize the value of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For those that are dishonor Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is their disgrace. And for whoever honors Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they will give honor. And this we conclude. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.